Hello everyone, I couldn't took video for a while because my laptop has some problems. Now I'm starting creating content. We saw how to connect to a Wi-Fi network or create a network. Now we will start using with some examples. As you know, we used MSYS32 to compile and flash the project up to now. I would like to explain another platform that we can compile, flash, and monitor our projects. This app is Visual Studio Code with ESP-IDF extension. This is more professional and easy to use. It brings many simplicity to us. We can use whole VS Code extensions and they helps us on the complex projects. We will see web server, WebSocket examples after this video. We will use HTML, CSS, JavaScript codes for WebSockets. And VS Code extensions are so useful for these tasks. I won't explain how to create the environment for VS Code because there are already lots of videos about it. Firstly, you should download VS Code from the official website. Then download latest version of Python and Git from its official website. After that, download ESP-IDF extension on VS Code. So if you downloaded whole file successfully, you got VS Code environment to compile your projects. If we compare this system with MSYS32, it has lots of useful features. Firstly, MSYS was a terminal, so you should use a text editor like Notepad or Sublime. We can write the code, flash and monitor it on VS Code. As we can see, this is editor, this is terminal. So it's called IDE. In VS Code, there are some useful extensions. Let me show this. First one is this. Thanks to this extension, brackets get visible colors. You can change theme of your VS Code. And this extension creates rainbow for inside of brackets. Live server extension is used to see demo version of WebSocket application. This extension is used for icons theme. Let me show it. As you can see, other file types have different icons. The last one is prettier. I think this is the best extension for us. Let's jump to C file. When we are writing or changing the code, sometimes lines could slide, we could write unnecessary spaces or two operations on same line. As you can see, the code don't seem good. When I press Ctrl S to save it, you see this extension fixed the code. And these buttons are used for ESP-IDF. This one is for port choosing. This one is used for manyconfig. This is used for build the project. This is used for flash it to the device. This is used for monitoring. The last one is used for building, flashing and monitoring the project. So you don't need to write make flash monitor, make manyconfig to the console. Lastly, these commands can be operated with keyboard shortcuts. Originally, these can be used with pressing Ctrl E and another letter. But we can change it. Press F1, write keyboard, then go preferences and open keyboard shortcuts. Then go to the ESP-IDF commands. If you want to change any of them, click on it and press your shortcut. For example, I assigned F2 for manyconfig, F3 for flash and monitoring, F4 for only monitoring, F8 for opening example projects. To sum up, this is how can we use VS Code for our projects. I think it's so useful and professional. I'll continue with VS Code for new topics. That's all I am going to talk about today. Stay motivated and subscribe me. Let's control the controllers together.